Now, next on our stage, the very famous and talented Joe Marzipan and his family of dancing bears.
Be cool and smell a flower. Make love, not war, and shower. Kiss the world and be groovy. Go ahead and make a googie.
Ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba, make a googie. Ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba, make a googie.
Slow down, you move too fast. You got to make the morning last. Just kicking down the cobblestones, looking for fun and feeling groovy. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da, feeling groovy.
Make sure that it's good and funny,
'cause films ought to make you laugh. They want to laugh, laugh, they want to laugh, laugh, they want to laugh, laugh, laugh.
Can Bobby laugh? Makes you feel alright. I don't care too much for money. Money can buy me love.
They said I went and I made some crazy cartoon voice because his name was Wacko, like the model Wacko there. And I just did some crazy thing and I got a callback. Now a callback is a second audition. That's when they like your first audition and they say, we'll see you again. So I go in there and I'm just bouncing off the walls and everything, and I started doing crazy voices, and Andre Romano, the director, said to me, she goes, hey, you do a lot of impressions, right? And I said, yeah. And she goes, why don't you try some impressions? And I said, like who? And she goes, try it like Elvis. Right? I'm not even kidding you guys. So I was like, hello, Merce. I don't know, maybe this Elvis is that ooh, you know, that is ridiculous, you know? Hey, yeah, I'm not wearing an advance, man. And it was weird. And I said, well, what about if we try to like, no, she said, what about if we did the Beatles? That's what it was. And I said, well, which one? And she went, you mean they sound different? You know, people don't just sound the same because they can't get the same way. I said, no, they sound totally different. I said, let me show you what I mean. Watch this, this is good.
So, you know, first you got John, you know, and John's voice was sort of like in his nose, and it sounded like it was like an arrow or something sharp, and then when he spoke, you know, talking like this one about yoga and give peace a chance and everything.
And this Paul, you know, Paul's voice is more like back in his throat, and it's a bit bacteria and high, and stuff, and there's some smoke in it and stuff, this is great. And then there's George, and George always sounded like he had a cold and was congested, and he talked very slowly like this, and then there's Reba down
at the bottom, you see. So they're all four letter different, and that's the Beatles, you see.
So I said, okay, well, which one do you want? She goes, why do you do it like Ringo?
So I'm like, hello, nurse, and I'm like, this is Fabu.
And then I saw this picture of him, and I said, well, he's just a small guy. So I took his voice and I made it small. So that's how you do it. You take a movie and bang it on the head. Next thing you know, and that's it.
These tranquil mountains are the perfect place to show the world the power of love and dental hygiene.
Yeah, man. It's good to get away from all those screaming girls. It's so peaceful here.
Yes, peaceful.
Tranquil.
It's so quiet.
There's no screaming.
I'm ruined.
Give us a kiss.
What kind of girl do you like?
John's wife.
John, I told you not to play on.
It's only
like a small
time. No.
Stay in bed.
Do you want to hold a penis too?
Everybody had a wet dream.
Called to getting into the cabana. Did any of you get hurt at all? Jill got kicked.
I got punched in my face a few times, but I mean that's part of life, isn't it? So,
we're rolling now. Right. We're gonna move the stage on down to New Orleans.
Go home.
Seems to vanish in the haze.
Yeah, very nice to be in Ireland, though.
Both bits.
But, yeah.
Have you been in any way flattered by the hysterical reaction of teenagers?
Yeah, very flattered.
It's been great. It was marvellous last night. Does. And we hope it'll be as good tonight.
You were very satisfied with the
Yeah, it was great. It was marvellous. The people are wonderful, you know. They go mad.
Loved that audience.
And six cars were arrested.
We were left in the
dressing. Well, don't look at me.
Well, if he's your grandfather, who knows?
He's a nice old man, isn't he?
He's very clean.
I am the wireless.
What's the matter, John, love? Blue meanies?
Now, look, I've had a marvellous idea. Just for once, let's all try to behave like ordinary, respectable citizens. Let's not cause any trouble, pull any strokes, or do anything I'm going to be sorry for. Especially tomorrow in that television theatre, because... Are you listening to me, Lennon?
You're a swine, isn't he, George?
You're a swine.
Thanks.